This is a great room.
Love it. Yes.
Whose place is this?
This is Wayne something. He's a big tall guy that was walking around.
Wayne. This is his place. Oh, okay. It's just a Reiki center. They do Reiki and all kinds of different healing. And they do events. They've been open for a few years.
Okay.
I used to do an event out of here a couple of times.
All right.
So thank you, ladies, for coming. Oh, and then we've got somebody that wants to sit in the back. What are you doing, Michelle?
I'm watching the door, and I'm watching your daughter, and I'm
helping. Oh, you're so good.
And you're doing a good job of it.
Right?
So you keep it
I'm
up.
Trying to stay...
We're going to say thank you.
Anonymous?
You did.
Anonymous?
Okay, I just received this card, and I guess I received it so I could share it with you.
Smile!
All right. Well, oh, Shelly's here as a guest.
Yeah.
Shelly, right?
Yeah.
O'Connor, thank you for coming. I'm going to move this out of the way a little bit. And so this is a Saturday, and what do people usually do on a Saturday? Either
clean the house.
Walk around in their PJs for a while or go out and play, but it's going to be 110. So this is an awesome place to be because you're going to learn and discover so many magnificent ways to take care of yourself. And I'm talking about self-healing today. I think that's a very important part of our knowledge, is to be able to self-heal. So I'll be sharing some amazing information on self-healing, why it's important to self-heal, well, duh, and how to implement self-healing. I'm sure many of you know that we are an energetic body as well as a physical body. So also thoughts and emotions are energy. Actually, emotions are energy in motion. So stop to think about how our thoughts create emotions. And then those emotions create beliefs. And from those beliefs, we develop patterns. And that's the way we perceive our world. The thing is that you create 85% of all of your patterns by the time you're 8 years old. Mm-hmm. So what does that mean? We're walking around as adults with the beliefs that we had as a child. Now that could be pretty scary or it could just be plain old fun. I want to make sure I cover everything, so I made myself a few notes, but it's really critical to understand how our thoughts and emotions affect us when it comes to self-healing. Your brain is like a computer, functions like a computer. Now your mind, that's another story. Your mind is in every single physical cell of your body. Your mind actually is the field of energy that creates your beingness, your liveness. Your mind is like the internet. You have a natural access to within you, to the material world around you, and to the infinite world that's beyond this world. In other words, your mind actually connects to the universe. And the information that's fed between you and the universe determines how you are, your beingness, your health, your clarity, your everything about you. Now, you're operating 90% of the time from your subconscious mind. That's your 8-year-old beliefs and patterns. And a lot of times we don't know why we do what we do, but it's from those beliefs and those patterns that you've developed. And I talk about this just because it is so crucial how your thoughts and emotions affect your body. The brain and the body receive information. And energy vibrates at different frequencies. So everything around you has a vibration. Everything's energy, so everything has a vibration. Everything vibrates at a specific level or speed. So what's happening? Think of a Okay, you're working on your computer or on your telephone. Okay, you've got Wi-Fi. And it kind of determines how clear your device is as to what kind of speed you're going to get. So when we're born, we're clear. We've got light shining through. We have clarity, we have perfect health. We won't go into kids that are born sick or whatever. But God made us to be perfect. Perfect in His eyes. Yes, if you need a cleanse, we have some up here. So, what happens when your computer or your phone or your device starts slowing down? Why does that happen? It happens because a bunch of garbage is coming in. Garbage that you may not even know got on your phone or on your computer. It's the same way with you and your body. And I'm going to have you help me on a little bit here. So, does anyone have any kind of worry or fears?
At this very moment?
Or overall, in general? Yes, Nancy.
Want to share what those worry or fears are?
Yeah, just say one word.
Loneliness.
Loneliness, okay.
So time this shortage. Is
what?
Time shortage.
Time shortage. Anybody else?
Money.
Money. Something else. You've got to go, a child or, yes.
Inadequacy.
Inadequacy. I'll make that a small one. Well, actually, sometimes that's really big.
So decisions.
Decisions. Worry about decisions that you make? Mm-hmm. Yeah, okay. What about, oh, my kid's out for the night. Are they going to make it in? Mm-hmm. Are they going to be an accident? What's going to happen?
No.
What about relationships? Anybody worry about their relationship?
What about judgment?
Hey.
Parents.
Parents. Oh, yes. I've got a mom back in Wisconsin. That's kind of a challenge
right
now.
Being injured and losing your independence.
Yes, losing your independence. What else?
Weather.
Weather?
It's dumb, but everybody seems to worry about it. Oh, too hot,
what's
too cold.
What's the weather going to be? It's going to rain today.
Politics. What about politics?
Politics.
Oh, yeah, the whole world.
Government.
Right.
So, as this happens, it's like the computer getting full of garbage. This is your body. Your body is getting sluggish and slowed down. The vibration, there's not hardly any light that can get through there, so you can communicate clearly and effectively with the universe. That is making you a creator. You are the creator of what's taking place with you and what's taking place inside your body. What happens here? Illness, stress, emotional stress, physical stress, aches and pains. So the question is, what do you do about it? First of all, I want to back up just a minute because I read the book, The Happiness Advantage by Sean Aker, and there was a gal, Ellen Langer, I believe was her name, and she wanted to prove just how much our minds, our thoughts, the way we conceive ourselves actually affects our physical beingness. So she had a group of 75-year-old men go on a retreat for 1 week. These guys are 75 years old. They didn't really know what the experiment was about, but they had to pretend they were 55 years old. So they, any books, magazines, media, anything had to be from 20 years prior. They dressed as if they were 55. They had ID badges with their pictures on it when they were 55. All they could talk about is what was going on 20 years earlier, about the politics, about their job, if they were working that job, everything from 20 years prior. Now before, they started this, they had testing done. You know, their memory, their strength, their flexibility, their blood work, everything was done. And then after that week, what do you think the results were?
They were healthy.
They were healthy. They turned back the time.
They did. They turned back the time. They were more flexible. They had more hand strength. 50% had more intelligence. They had, overall, on average, they looked 3 years younger. And that was after 1 week. So that just tells you how the power of our mindset really determines our reality. Now, back to how do we heal ourselves? I think maybe it has something to do with our thoughts. I want to talk a little bit about how I got involved with energy healing. It's been over a couple decades, actually. I ran across Gary Craig with EFT, the tapping, emotional freedom technique. And I was very, very curious about this. So I started studying it a little bit. My 9-year-old granddaughter was spending the night. She was growing so fast that the pain in her legs was excruciating. She was bawling. So we're in the middle of our bathroom, and I'm trying to figure out what I can do for her. I'm thinking, tapping. So we sat down in the middle of the floor, her legs crossed, at the big bathroom. And I said, sweetheart, let's give this a shot. I went through the cycle one time. Maybe 1 minute. I said, how do you feel now? She's looking around with this really weird look on her face like, it's gone. The pain was completely gone. And I'm like, oh, I'm hooked. All I did for the next decade, about the next decade or so, is learn more about the EFT. I shared it online. I did videos online, which I still have on YouTube, on our YouTube site. I did a series of 10 for teenagers about peer pressure, depression, all kinds of things I could think of that teenagers go through. So all that's free online. And then I got with my business partner, Vicki, because I'm co-owner of Queen Bee Biz with Vicki Pellman. And we started Queen Bee Biz, sharing what we've learned. She was a Reiki master, Sedona certified. I was doing the tapping and the EFT. And we were just sold on all of this energy healing that we could share with other people. And that's all we wanted to do, share what we learned with as many people as were willing to listen. Then in 2016, I met Dr. Eric Pearl. Dr. Eric Pearl was a very respected and successful chiropractor in LA for about 12 years. And Reconnective Healing, which it is called today, was a gift that found him. He had no clue about energy work, anything like that. And so he didn't know what he had. And then he realized that he was meant to share this with the world. And so for over 20 years, all he's done is gone around the world and trained people on Reconnective Healing. Now, what happens, Reconnective Healing is actually a science-backed process. Okay, there's no rituals, no tools, no techniques. What's happening is I'm interacting with your frequencies. And the interaction is, I'm dealing with three elements, energy, light, and information. Now, we've already talked about energy, and just a little bit about light. And what happens with the light and the vibrations and the frequencies is the information that you receive. When I first met Dr. Eric Pearl, and he did his demo, a little spiel, I was up front, and he had me feel the frequencies. I didn't feel anything, because what he's doing, and I can do this later, afterwards, with anybody that wants to experience it. I didn't feel anything, as he's playing around, but my thing was going like that. And I was not doing it. I'm like, whoa, this is weird. But anyway, some of the different stuff that he was doing, I knew that that was what I wanted to get involved in. So myself, I got certified in that. I also got certified in the personal reconnection, which is reconnective healing is hands-off process, where I'm just, you're on a massage table, and I'm just feeling and finding the frequencies and interacting with them so that you can have a clearer path to the universe, the information that puts you in optimum harmony and balance. And I'll go into that a little bit more. But what happens is I interact with the frequencies, I'm just feeling and finding. The personal reconnection is a two-session process. It has to be done within 72 hours, both sessions. And I am focusing on 118 specific points in your body instead of just feeling and finding them on 118 different points. And that's when you're really to really just go supercharged. The experience I had when I had the reconnective healing, because I had to have a session before I could go get certified, I really didn't think too much happened. I didn't seem to feel too much. I felt some like weird vibration or trembling and stuff. But then as I was talking to the practitioner, I said, you know what? While I was on that table, it was like I could breathe better than I could ever breathe before. And I grew up with asthma. So I never felt that type of breathing. And after that, before that, I could not be in my son's house for more than 5 minutes because they have cat and dogs. After that, I could go in and stay as long as I wanted. So I guess that's a pretty big deal.
Good for you.
So, and with the personal reconnection, when I had that, I was... Once again, I didn't feel like a whole lot took place. I kind of felt like, oh, straighter, more confident, a little more courageous. But within a few weeks after that, Vicki and I took our Queen Bee Biz ladies up for a retreat up in Duck Creek. And usually, I'm the one that sits back a little bit. I let Vicki take charge and just kind of follow suit with that. I was right up there. I was, boom, I was clear. I was concise. I was right on the spot. Vicki goes, whoa, what happened to you? And so you never know what's going to happen. Whatever takes place is in your highest good at the time. So let's say you come in for knee pain, but there's an emotional issue that needs to be taken care of. Remember, thoughts and emotions plug in your body. So as I'm interacting with those frequencies, I'm clearing the way. I'm actually creating an entrainment. So entrainment, I guess the best way to say is like tuning forks. Okay, get a tuning fork, get another one, and this one gets entrained with the first one. So what's happening is I'm interacting with the frequencies. Your vibration is coming up to match that frequency. I'm just the catalyst. My job is to get out of the way. I don't care to know what's wrong with you or what's going on or why you're there. I just feel and find, and then you are getting your pathway to the universe for clarity, to clear up illness, to clear up pain. So as I'm running through, finding those frequencies, clearing these up, you are becoming more relaxed, more peace, less pain, whatever is needed at the time for you, so that the light can shine through and provide the information that your body needs to accomplish optimum harmony and balance in your body. Let's see where I want to go with all of this.
Can I ask a question real quick?
Yes.
I don't want to interrupt
you.
That's just my bad
personality.
That's fine.
You said the two sessions have to be done within 72 hours. Does it mean 72 hours apart, or it could be 12 hours apart or 24?
You have your first session, and then it has to be later than 24 hours, but no longer than 72 hours.
Thank you.
Good question.
So the other thing that happens is with reconnective healing, you don't even have to be there. It works remotely because it works on the quantum level. And so let's look at it this way. We live in a four-dimensional world. A lot of people think three, height, width, depth. But as Einstein explained, also time. And scientists have actually noted that they're really, time is illusional. So everything's happening at the same time, in the same space. Even though that doesn't make any logical sense. And I have a logical mind. But anyway. So look at it this way. Scientists have noted that time is moving faster. You know, we just say it that way to make sense. Okay? It's expanding in all different directions. Faster. So it's like we live in this balloon, okay, and so it's expanding, it's getting thinner and thinner and thinner. And the energy inside of that balloon is interacting with the energy outside of that balloon. And the way I like to see it in my mind is like a sci-fi movie where you put your hand through time and you're in this other dimension. That's where reconnective healing works. And I love all the other modalities, the tapping, the Reiki, anything else. I just feel that reconnective healing is more. Just from my experience, from the results I've received, that other people have received. And it's, I really believe, along with Dr. Mary Pearl, that reconnective healing is the future of healthcare. Do I go see a chiropractor? Yeah, I see a chiropractor. Do I go get massages to help get muscles fixed? Yeah, I do. Now, about the self-healing part, for you to be able to self-heal, this is Dr. Eric Pearl, Dr. Eric Pearl's book, Heal Others, Heal Yourself. It clicked one day, I don't know how long after I read the book, Heal Others. Oh, as you're healing others, you're healing yourself. Duh. And this tells his story, and in the back it tells how you can feel the frequencies yourself. So when Vicki and I first read the book, we learned it. So her husband had an issue with his toe. So she's going, didn't know what she was doing, right? So she's going, yes. didn't really know what was going on, but it still felt better, you know? So learning how to do this from his book is like learning how to brush your teeth, really getting a true, a more effective healing is having a practitioner work on you, like with your teeth, a dental hygienist does it deeper and cleaner. Now, Dr. Eric Pearl has training going on, like he did here in Vegas back in 2016. So his next training is in July. It's in Spain. If anybody wants to go to Madrid, Spain, you can always just go to his site and get all the details on it. But there's also one in August in Florida and one in September in Denver. To feel the frequencies, I have a special which I put on your chairs. So it's normally $95. If you purchase it today, it's $75. That's remote only. And I tell you what, remote is just as good or better than in person. If you want it in person, it's going to be the $95. But you also get our Sweet Success Journal. Now, Vicki and I created a process to help you just change your thoughts, which changes your emotions. So the process is in here, it's the first few pages, and then the rest is blank for you to fill in. So you get this free, that's a $20 value there. And I have a few books for sale up front too, if you want any of these books. The frequencies, if you want to feel the frequencies, we can play with that a little bit. Marianne, you want to feel the frequencies? Okay, come on up here.
Sometimes they do, sometimes they don't. I've never felt it. I've just felt you would do things to me.
Oh, that's right. Yeah. Okay, so let everybody know what we did.
We were at a retreat at the beginning of the year, and I had been dealing with shoulder pain for weeks. Like, I couldn't tie my bra, I couldn't do this, I couldn't raise my arms, it was horrible at the gym. And we're at a retreat, and I think you saw me.
Well, no, you put your arm up on the table, you go, oh, I wish this would stop hurting.
Yes, and she said, why didn't you say something? Well, I thought thoughts, right? I was thinking thoughts. And so she stood behind me, and she started doing, and my fingers started doing this thing, and then I was wearing something, remember? I was wearing a bracelet, and you asked me to move it or take it off because you said there's a block here, and I was feeling at that particular moment pain there. I can't remember if I took the bracelet off or moved it, and then it just continued, but I was able to.
Yeah.
And
how's it now? Can you raise it?
Yeah. And I did that the entire rest of the week, and I was like, oh my gosh, look, because I hadn't had full mobility.
And that was like 3 minutes, maybe.
Yeah, we were on break.
We were talking.
Yeah.
You and I, Meg Natalina, were talking, discussing stuff.
Yep.
And Carmen in our group, we were doing a one-on-one, and I did this. Okay, so just hold your hand out like this, and spread your fingers apart, and just look at your hand, because when we're looking at our hand, our thoughts are actually creating energy too. So what I do is I just connect. And then I start interacting. Feeling nothing or something? Sometimes I'll get with people, and they'll just be, I have one gal who was like, her whole body was coming towards me. And sometimes people's fingers will start moving. And sometimes, if you don't feel it right now, you might even feel it later in the day.
Your wrists are tingling right over here.
Okay. It gets stronger for me too. And that's all it is. So remotely, fun. Thank you. Okay, so with Carmen, I did that with her, and then we kept talking afterwards, and she said, I'm sure it's all like this. I'm like, what? She goes, okay. I was in an auto accident 3 years ago, and I had 3 pins in my wrist, and I fell on it the other day, and I thought for sure I was going to have to have surgery again. She goes, I can't really do anything with it. I've got all this typing to do, and I can't even do that. She says, no, there's no pain. 15, 20, 30 seconds, and still, she even says in the meetings now, months later, it's fine, no pain.
Yeah.
Do you
do it on dogs or pets?
I do. Anything. Everything's energy. So.
Everything is energy.
So remotely, I've got clients in Wisconsin, California, Kansas. All I do is call up. I can set the person up. I get them. Set up the way I want them to, and then I just pretend like they're in front of me.
What's the procedure for pets?
It doesn't matter. What were we doing when I facilitated?
You were just standing behind me.
I stand behind you, we were talking, it doesn't matter.
Right, but can you do it remotely on pets?
Oh, yes,
okay.
Yes, definitely.
So, do I need to put her in her bed?
No, she doesn't.
Anything?
I have a couple clients that had
my
pets.
My head's on fire, by the way.
I figured it would really affect you.
On fire, yes.
Yeah, just.
It's okay.
I know.
Yeah.
I don't believe you. So, where was we going with this?
Go ahead. I'm sorry.
Why is it bad? Yes.
Oh, no. It was clients that bought sessions for their family. So I facilitated sessions on their family without them even knowing it. Mm-hmm. I had no idea where they were or what they were doing. I just put in mind's eye. In the session, she goes, oh my God, you won't believe what happened. So yeah, pretty cool. Time's up. I appreciate everyone. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
I'm going to talk about
food
with you.
Yeah,
go by.
Very nice.
Yeah.
Oh, you know what? I had this on and it wasn't on. That was good.
Uh-oh.
So, this is a recorder because when the camera's far away, it doesn't really strip. coming. Don't forget that. Thank you, Shelley, for coming. Thank you, ladies.
This is great.
Madeline. Good hugger.
All the speakers are in here, correct?
Yes.
So I can just leave my
Yes, you can.